Evet, Cars'ında 2 gün sonra çıkıyor değil mi Cars? Ama Night City Wire'ı sunan ablam ne yazık ki artık sunmuyor. Çünkü o Frontier'de çalışıyor. FB Manager'da çalışıyor artık o.
Welcome to this special episode of Night City Wire. The show from us at the Project Red where we
Biz bunu YouTube'dan izlediğimizde altyazısı var mıydı ya?
This is the month of Edgerunners and today is packed with content. We got trailers, interviews and some Night City Wire exclusives coming your way. We'll start with checking in with one of the creators of the show, Bartosz Tibor, to see if I can get any more secrets about the show before it releases on Netflix September 13th. Then we'll dive deeper into the next game content release for Cyberpunk 2077, which we're calling, you guessed it, the Edgerunners update. And it goes live today.
Aa, bugün. Finally, bayağı bildiğim bugün Edgerunners update'i geliyormuş.
To discuss the past, present and future of Cyberpunk.
Ve Cyberpunk geleceği için birkaç şey de konuşacaklarmış. Evet evet, bu Edgerunner skin büyük ihtimalle bu arada. Edgerunner için çok heyecanlıyım. Edgerunner update'i çok büyük ihtimalle skin. Ama asıl olay zaten o değil. Asıl olay future of Cyberpunk. I knew from day one I'd never belong there.
So why stick around for so long?
Was kind of her dream all that. Ay, İngilizce dublaj çok kötüymüş.
It's not your dream though, is it? Come on, got something to show you.
3, 2, 1, showtime.
Ya bu inşallah NFSF şeyini göstermiyorlardır. Evet, trailer'da sikiş var. Bir kenara alalım mı? Trailer'da sikiş var çünkü. Biz gitmeyelim Uzlam. Uzlam link vereyim, siz onu izleyin. Yok, o kısmı çıkarmışlar galiba. Yok, göstermişler. Şey yaptım. Çok güzel arkadaşlar, siz izlersiniz.
Don't make a name for yourself as a cyberpunk by how you live.
Siri Link. Oğlum YouTube'a girin. Cyberpunk Edgerunner yazın. Çıkıyor zaten. Çok güzel gözüküyor. Arkadaşlar bir buba, ben bat. Ne oluyor? Her şey patlıyor abi. Herkesin içinden geçtiler. Ama Twitch'te yayınlanıyor. Yani patlamayalım. Zaten en çok izlenen kısmına bakın, videonun görürsünüz. I have stellar expectations for you too. Netflix'te yayınlanacak haftaya.
That is one awesome kaldı. Trailer, and what's even more awesome is actually watching anime in Japanese. And I still remember watching things like Ghost in the Shell and Dragon Ball, which was one of my favorite animes as a kid. And yeah, I would watch in Japanese. But for those that want to watch it in different languages, what can we expect in terms of the VOs for Cyberpunk Edgerunners?
We have Japanese, we have English, Polish, German, French, 12 voiceovers.
12 tane farklı dublaj varmış ve çok altyazılı.
I love when everything is fully localized.
Ustam bu kadar büyük konuşmayı Cyberpunk hakkında yapmayın.
Enjoy it, so kudos for that. Okay, speaking of Edgerunners, let's set the scene. So for those hearing about Edgerunners for the first time, what is Cyberpunk Edgerunners and who actually is an Edgerunner?
Okay, so Edgerunner is a person that is a mercenary, a rebel.
Paralı asker.
Fights the law, fights the system.
Sisteme
çatışan. Nice bikes.
Ya motosikletleri olan.
And pahalı Cyberpunk parçaları olan David Martinez,
David Martinez diye birisinin hikayesiymiş. Edge Runner olmak isteyen bir çocuğun hikayesiymiş. Sonra her şeyini kaybediyormuş bir gün.
This thing is a very powerful and dangerous cyberware who can change his life forever. And
now the question ama is, her şeyi kaybettiği zaman çok pahalı bir cyberware veriyormuş, bütün hayatını değiştiriyormuş o.
And fulfill his dream or not.
Okay. Is the story in Cyberpunk Edgerunners canon? So for those who have played the game, should
bu,
you
hani,
play the
gerçek
game,
mi? Hikayeye bağlı mı olacak? Hani canon mı olacak
the
diyor.
Like, what's the way to go here? Or can you experience both without having one and the other?
You can do both at the same time.
Perfect.
But it is canon. It's 100%
canonmış, evet, bu arada.
Canon.
Yani
so
evrende
game,
bu da gerçekmiş.
You will feel like home while watching Cyberpunk Edgerunners. It's the same city, same streets, same cars, same guns. You will also meet the same characters, you know, from the game.
Oyunda gördüğümüz karakterleri de görecekmişiz diyor.
If you're a fan, you'll be totally excited.
Bazı oyundaki sure karakterleri de görecekmişiz
I
diyor.
And there were some characters which I was very happy
güzel
to see,
bu arada.
And I did not expect them, so that was really cool.
But also, don't worry if you don't know the game.
Oyunu bilmiyorsan da endişelenmeyin diyor.
Cyberpunk Edgerunners is a standalone story that will suck you in. I think it's amazing. Like you will fall in love with characters, with the city.
Karaktere aşık olacaksınız, şehre aşık
David,
olacaksınız.
And I think that after you experience what David is doing in the anime,
şehrin içinde ne yapacaklar bize acaba?
In the game.
What about the style of anime and cyberpunk? What do you think about this marriage? So does this work in your opinion?
Anime ve cyberpunk birbirine uyuyor mu?
You know, when I'm thinking about cyberpunk, I see a few things. I see Neuromancer, a book by William Gibson, Blade Runner, a book and a movie, and two great animes, Akira and Ghost in the Shell.
Reklamdan niye bu kadar fazla?
If you are doing a TV series,
çünkü insanlar TV için reklam için mantıklı bir platform olduğunu fark ettiler, o yüzden basıyorlar.
Anime format. I think it's just
ondan.
A perfect fit.
Yani eskiden
okay,
reklam yoktu Twitch'te, o yüzden
shell.
Görmüyordunuz.
How can we compare
Twitch hep böyleydi yurt dışında.
Cool classics to Cyberpunk Edgerunners.
They are different. Cyberpunk has much more palm trees, but the main difference for me personally is the city. Night City is always the main protagonist or antagonist. So it's never about one
şehrin,
linear story about one character.
Şu şey gibi tanımlıyor ki için. Tek bir karakter için değil, şehir yani birkaç
compelling, unique people that have problems,
yani hep belli bir grup hakkında böyle hani bir insanları anlatıyor, şehri anlatıyor. Hani asıl hep yani amacımız hep hikayeyi anlatmak, bir hikaye değil hikayeleri anlatmak, şehri anlatmak.
Rooting for them, you already are picking favorites yeah. and characters that you kind of can associate yourself with, which
öyle
was something
diyor.
That I did like subconsciously just by watching.
So
she has a couple wicked. Like you know nuts loose, but she's really really cool. Okay, we saw in the trailer that the anime is made in collaboration with Studio Trigger. For
Studio
those
Trigger'la
that
beraber
don't know
Studio Trigger, gördük. Studio Trigger'ı bilmeyenler varsa.
I know. But some
maybe
don't. What are they known for?
Okay, so first of all, Studio Trigger, huge love. They are legends. They created one of the best animes in the world. Darling in the Franxx, Kill la Kill, Little Witch Academia. And before creating Studio Trigger, they also worked on a cult classic called Neon Genesis Evangelion.
Nice. Yeah, I watched that
İyi
one.
Stüdyoyla anlaşmışlar.
And I still go back from
tamam.
time to time.
Onu ben bile biliyorum yani.
Like I said, it's a classic.
It is, yeah.
So what was Studio Trigger's involvement on
Neon Genesis ve Evangelion'u ben bile biliyorum.
He created a story.
İzlemedim ama.
Then gave all the scripts to Studio Trigger and they adapted it into anime format. Because the idea was we wanted to create
İzlemeyeceğim o zaman, anime izlemeyeceğim. Çizgi film izlemiyorum.
So grounded, gritty, and especially character driven. But what we wanted to
çizgi film izlemiyorum.
Was unique visuals. And you saw the trailer.
Come on, lan.
Studio Trigger are the most stylish people in the anime business. Their storytelling is over the top. And the camera movement is like a roller coaster ride.
Yeah.
So our story, their visuals, it's perfect fit.
Yeah, and the animation style is also like very over the top. When you see all the action scenes, they're so fine tuned and so like, you know, dynamic that it, you know, breathes a little bit more like life to the whole thing, which I personally really, really enjoyed. So we touched a little bit upon the story. So without spoiling anything, what can we expect biraz bahsettik.
Ne bekleyebiliriz? Hikayeden ne bekleyebiliriz? Bu arada bu dizi kötü olursa hikayeden kötü olacak.
Okay, so David will be fighting dinosaurs on Mars and stuff like no, I'm joking, but it's
çünkü görsel olarak çok güzel gözüküyor.
Of mercenaries
görsel olarak çok güzel gözüküyor abi bu.
That's a lot. So David yani. Will be experiencing a lot of things. He will meet crazy adrenaliners.
10 bölüm olacakmış. Bütün Nice hayatını yaşayacak. Gangsterlarla kapışacak. Nice'de 8 gang var. Onlarla tanışacak. Cyber Psycho'larla tanışacakmış. Aa, Cyber Psycho'lar varmış.
Chase scene, a motor chase scene. Even a car chase scene with an ambulance.
We will ambulansla araba kovalamacı sahnesi olacakmış.
Including one on the moon. So maybe David will
öpüşmeler varmış. Haram.
I won't spoil
Harem Usta, Fahri Baba, çok 18 milyar bir şey canım sizin.
I'm already sold. I watched it. I will rewatch it again once it airs on Netflix for sure. Bartek, thanks for the interview. It's always amazing to talk to you. 20 milyar bir şey
canım sizin. En iyi abinem sana hoş geldin.
That's all about the anime for now. We're looking forward to binging the series once again.
Zaten daha anlatmışlar, spoiler'ı görmek istemiyorum.
Up next, we're going to talk about the upcoming game update for Cyberpunk 2077. In a moment, we'll join game director Gabe Amatangelo to learn more. But before we do that, check out the Edgerunners update trailer.
Cyberpunk'ın şimdi Edgerunners update'i. Bu akşam geliyormuş bu arada bu.
You get your beauty sleep? Time you got up.
Ustam bu yataktan kalkmayalım artık. Yani yatağa karakteri koymanız 4 update aldı. Nudisi mi dedi? Oh no.
And then see in a city that lets you get by without buddies.
Oyundakinden bir şey olmaz. Oy nudinden bir şey olmaz. Nude seks mi? Nerede? Evet.
Balance, friendship, love.
Ulan boyu çok güzeldi. Daha iyi olabilirdi. Çok üzülüyorum şu anda.
The hell else we supposed to fight for?
Aa, bizim abi. Nasıl ejderhanı oluyorum? Ne update ne? Tamam, update hakkında hiçbir şey anlatmadın. Neyse, Witcher oyunu. Ceket var işte, o kadar mı? Tamam.
Oh crap, sorry, we're on. I was actually thinking of a non-scripted way in order to tell you about something awesome, which is Road Trace, and you can play it later today on your phone. Yes,
İndirdim.
Android or İndirdim. iOS, it's coming. It's free to play.
İndirdim.
It has bir de, no microtransactions.
Bir de
and it's freaking awesome.
iOS'ta anasına söyleyeyim Roach için.
Your screen. Gabe, did you see this?
I have. I've seen early versions of it too.
It's freaking amazing.
It's very cool, yes.
Yeah.
And you
yeah.
play it in the game, in the Cyberpunk game as well.
Yeah.
Cyberpunk'ta da oynayabiliyor musun?
Perfect.
We'll talk about that more later, I guess.
Yeah, we will.
Oyla niye getirmiyor Cyberpunk'a? İptal ettiler onu ondan.
All right. We're here to talk about you,
No, we're here to talk about the game.
Yes.
But I'll introduce myself.
Yes. Bu arada, good and tell everybody what
bu arada ne söylüyorum? Witcher benim en sevdiğim oyunlardan birisidir. Roach bok gibi bir at. Bir, yani o bir oyundaki en kötü atlardan birisi. En kötü kullanabileceğin at yani. Çalışmıyor abi.
What? I did the Stewie. I did the Stewie turn.
We'll get to that though.
All right, all right.
We'll get to
yes,
that.
Yes, we will.
But about that, before we get to all that, let's kind of go back in time. Let's talk about the past and the updates that were happening for
geçmişten bahsedelim. Geçmişten bence çok bahsetmeyin, inanır mısın?
So what in your opinion is kind of the landmark update for the game that you think had the biggest influence? Like there was a lot of stuff going on recently.
Well, I'd say it's a combination of 1.5 and 1.3. Mm-hmm. Ton of bug fixes. Also,
bug fix sort of a
kind of overhaul and re-architecture for a bunch of fundamental systems to get
temel
it working smooth across all platforms.
Yep. Daha, as well as to set the stage for future features and updates and stuff like that. Ve
so you started about 1.5, I want to continue with that. What's your feeling about Cyberpunk 2077 and how the game feels and looks right now after that update?
Update'den sonra hani ne değiştiğini düşünüyorsun diyor.
Like I said, we smooth out a bunch of stuff and I think Cyberpunk 2077 can be kind of fully experienced as intended for you know the world, this character.
Kendileri bile bunu kabul etmesi çok
kind of
üzücü ya.
We also had an opportunity to get in some of the community requested features
hani,
such as
bu artık şu anda istendiği şekilde oynanabilir seviyedeyiz diyor.
Being able to get new apartments and customize them to some extent. A bunch of different little things like cleaning up the map, the user experience, getting rid of some of the pain points in general.
Aynı zamanda
kind of
artık
the real flow was
topluluğun istediği bazı özellikleri falan da yaptık. Minimap ki harbiden minimap olayı çok önemliydi. Onları da filan yaptık. Gelecek update'lerde de şey getiriyoruz diyor.
The actual sort of next gen kind of fidelity with the different visual modes and stuff like that. Beautiful, very dense Night City and very moody Night City, being able to experience them in the next gen consoles as well as PC. Hugely beautiful.
Dude, now I just want to say I'm even more excited to replay the game myself once again. So yeah, thank you for that. So we're talking about the present. So we have the Edgerunners update, which is freaking amazing. We saw the mashup trailer with similarities between the anime as well as
öyle bir şey yok. O kadar reklam yiyemezsin. Şöyle söyleyeyim. Bir saat içinde bir yayıncının atabileceği reklam sınırı var yani. O yüzden çok aptalca geliyor.
So yeah, really fun cooperation with the
anime, as you
saw, just like yani, stuff straight out of Night City world there in the game. You'll be able to get Martina's jacket.
Bilmiyorum yani.
It takes place during the same kind of timeline.
They
don't cross paths, but we do have a quest that kind of seeds in some of the stuff and some of the Easter eggs from the anime.
Ha, Edgerunner update'inde bir iki tane daha böyle quest koymuşlar, görev koymuşlar. Bu görevlerin dışında da bu görevlerin dışında da özel silahlar falan varmış.
That's the big one, right?
Nice.
AKA Transmog, AKA being able to completely customize and tailor your outfits as you want to roleplay. Slot by slot to kind of
Allah'ım ya Rabbim.
Currently have equipped.
Çok şükür ya Rabbim.
Also update the Ripper docs.
Çok şükür.
And do some resculpting of your face, resculpting of your
body. Çok şükür
yani. We added new options in entirely for all this stuff as well as some of the cosmetics and hair and stuff like that you can still do at your mirror. You can also do that at the Ripper dock as
Transmog
well.
Transmog şu olayı abi.
There's a bunch of things in this update.
Skill olarak o armorun özelliği olarak bu armoru kullanıyorsun ama istediğin herhangi bir dizaynı kullanabiliyorsun.
And of course, Roach Race.
Öyle
it's
diyeyim.
The first of our sort of in-game arcade cabinets that you can actually play in the game. And you're playing as that mythical beast from a faraway land
Yemen,
named after
oh
a fish
yani,
and not a smoking paraphernalia or a gross bug, but a fish. This is what the IP gods had told me.
Yes, true, true. And Nibbles the cat in photo mode.
Yes, Nibbles the cat in photo mode in various different positions and stuff like that.
Exactly.
So you can customize. Yeah. So post your pictures.
Yeah, perfect.